9:42 is your time. It's been a month since the presidential election, and the financial world has had some time to react to the upcoming changes. So what could this mean for your investments and retirement in the upcoming year? Senior financial planner Chuck Conrad has a look ahead to 2017. And are we seeing any changes? Are people either upset or just letting things stay the course?
Well, we're seeing a euphoria with the U.S. equity market. So on election night, which was fascinating, we would see the Dow futures were down 800 points, and people would wake up in the morning thinking, there's going to be absolute chaos, and suddenly the market was up pretty significantly and continued to go up. So there's, in terms of fiscal policy, there's been a euphoria with the U.S. Market. There's hope that, you know, because Trump really talked quite a bit about, almost similar to a Ryan plan of significantly reduced personal income tax and corporate tax, and that will stimulate growth, which was one of the two main themes. So this business growth, but then we've got this other side, this protectionist bucket. You know, on the economic side, you need congressional approval. The concern is on the protectionist side. You know, I want to renegotiate NAFTA. We're going to increase tariffs.
Pacific deal, right.
You know, we're going to restrict immigration. All of that can really be done in the White House. So we've got this, you know, the international markets went down pretty significantly and have leveled off. The bond markets went down pretty significantly and have leveled off. Emerging markets have really been hit hard, and it's mainly because of that protectionist
Because that's mentality. And that's a lot of the concern too, for especially with people that may have investments in foreign markets or in foreign interests. That's where they're a little concerned that they may lose some of that investment, I would imagine.
Well, they're concerned that they may lose some of that investment. My gut feeling says that the economic side is going to dominate, and the protectionist side is not going to be as extreme as we might tend to believe. You know, one of my majors in college was political theory, and I love politics, but I hate politicians. Everybody loves Congress, but everybody hates Congress, but they love their congressman.
Right.
So, you know, the protectionist side, I have to balance, you know, how he really feels and what was said to generate votes. And we don't know really yet how that's going to play out.
Well, one of the things too is that the fact that Republican president, Republican Congress, do we see any changes, or will that kind of create stability in the markets for some folks?
Well, I think we're going to see less gridlock, but I think we also have to remember that not all Republicans agree with one another. And on top of it, you know, President-elect Trump was a Democrat before he was a Republican. So he's not really your traditional Republican. So there might be some headbutting that occurs. And I think that's going to be natural. What's going to be interesting is we see his cabinet appointments. And that's going to give us an idea as to how policy is really going to be shaped. And after an election, it's absolutely normal for the losing side to cry foul with cabinet appointments, like, I can't believe, you know, this is the selection. And they do it to an extreme that way to encourage some sort of compromise. What we're seeing is Democrats crying foul about cabinet appointments, many of whom have been, you know, against the agency that they're, you know, designated to run. And that can be a positive thing. If you're against the EPA, maybe as the head of it, your goal is to make it more efficient, better. It's not necessarily
A bad thing for some. And some people may see it that
way. And I'm going to choose to be optimistic. You know, in the Army, we would say, you don't salute the person, you salute the rank,
right?
And you have respect for the rank, and until something dramatic happens, I think we just
stay the course.
Stay the course. Yeah, I'm fiercely independent. I'm wearing my purple tie today. neither Republican nor Democrat. Mm-hmm. In terms of where we're going from here, mm-hmm. I think we have to be concerned about the euphoria with the U.S. market, and the real opportunities are the downtrodden. I had somebody say that they couldn't imagine why anybody would buy bonds. Interest rates are going up. Mm-hmm. Bonds in 1976 to 81, when rates went up incredibly, bonds never had a down year, the aggregate bond index.
Okay, well, I tell you what, we're running a little bit out of time.
All right.
So you know what, but if for more information, for more good advice, you can always go to for more information on Szarka Financial Services and what they have to offer. We have a link on our website. Just click on TV. And really, for more information about that, just give you guys a call.
Happy to talk about it.
All right, AJ, let's toss it over to you.